Teska Technologies Private Limited. Today we are going to understand the programmable logic controller trainer kit. The order code for this trainer kit is 52014. In this trainer kit, we are using Siemens Symatec S7200 series PLC. This PLC's model number, CPU model number is SR20. For this, we have to understand what is a PLC. A programmable logic controller or PLC is a specialized computer-like device used to replace bank of electromagnetic relays in industrial process. This will be very useful to this is very useful to understand the PLC very easily for education purpose. So first we have to power on the circuit. For this, we connect the AC power supply to the trainer kit and power on the PLC. Now we have to connect quetch code for the LED outputs from M to ground and L to 5 volt. Now for communication of the PLC, we have to use the CAT6 LAN cable. There are also interface port for RS485, but it will be used for connection of HMI. Now there are port for LAN cable, so we connect the LAN cable here, and the other end of the LAN cable we will connect to the PC. For programming of this PLC, we have the Step 7 Microwin Smart Siemens Mac software, programming software. So we go through with this. Here, now we will select a new project and the processor. Here we will select the CPU. Our CPU is SR20 AC-DC relay. So there will be select the CPU now. Okay. In starting, we will explaining the NONC. The first experiment is about how to use NO and NC bit in the PLC. Normally open contact means NO means normal condition, the contact are open. So if the electrical supply is present state, it will not operate. The moment you apply the external source, this will be operate and the supply will pass through. So from there are the bit logics. Here we can select a NO contact and we can put there. And now we will have to define the question mark, what is the input we are addressing this NO contact. So the input 0 of PLC are we are addressing there. Now for the output, we are using the output bit here and we have to assign an output address here. The output 0 we will assign here. Now for downloading this program, there is the option for download. There is our CPU. From communication we can select the CPU. This is the IP of our PLC. Now we will connect OK and the download is click to download begin. So here we download the program. The CPU is in stop mode right now. That's why it is prompted us to stop the CPU first. So we have to stop the CPU first. Now this will program, the program has been completed, download successfully. Now we turn back to run mode the PLC. For the understanding the programming, we will start the simulation from this program test, program status, time step. We will compare the PLC with this. This is passed. Now continue. We will use the toggle switch defined for the programming. Now as the toggle switch is fixed, the input will go through the PLC and the output will be come. Now in NO condition, there is no supply provided to the PLC input. So as the supply provided, the PLC input goes through and we get the input here. and the output also there. So this is the NO function with the, in this PLC. So NO function, as the supply are removed, the output also removed. Now, for turn back to programming, we have to first stop the simulation and stop the processor also. The processor will be stopped now, and we are get back to programming. For this, now we understand the NC logic. For NC logic, we will select the NC bit from here for input. Now, for the reprogramming of the PLC, we have to first stop the simulation here and stop the processor as well. Now, we are going to understand the NC logic. For NC logic, it described as when the power supply is on or the input is coming to the PLC continually, the output will not be the output remains low, and as the output output goes to low, as the input goes to low, the output will be high. For this, we select the NC bit here and we assign the input 0 to this, and we delete this. So now we also download it again PLC. Download successful, and we run the PLC and we start the simulation. Now the output is the input supply is not provided to PLC, but the output is at high bit. As we on the supply to high, the output will go off. So this is the NC logic we are performing here. For saving the program, we have to first stop the simulation and going to save the file as project 1. We can assign this Tesca PLC trainer 1 and we can save it there. So anytime we want to read this or work on that program, we will open from the documents. Now we will learn a T-on delay timer. In the industrial scenario, where many times we have to assign some time delay to any process for the completion of the process. So here we will use a timer T on for the this process. For this, we use bit logic input. We assign this input 0. Now from there are the timers. We can use there are the timer instruction specified in the help section of the this software. There are T on delay timer, off delay timer, as well retentive timer. So we select here T on or T off first. For the resolution of 100 millisecond, 10 millisecond or 1 millisecond, the timer address are already defined. So we have to use the timer what are defined to according to software. But if we assign any timer like T37, we assign for T on timer, but we cannot assign T37 to T off as well. We have to assign another timer address to the another timer delay. So we first use T37 timer. So we first assign the T on timer for there. Now we assign T37 address to this, and here we assign 50 seconds as because the base is 100 milliseconds, the timer will on the output after a delay of 5 seconds. So here we use input logic and where you we use timer 37 output and assigning the output 0, sorry, the output zero for this. Now our program has done for finding any errors in the specified program, we have to compile this program. So there are no error found. If there any error present, the compiler will show the error to us. So now the program is had no error. So we have downloaded this program to the PLC. Download successful. Now we start the real-time simulation also. So here the as we hide the input 0, the output will not come. The output will the timer is on, then output will come after the 5 seconds. We can again see this process carefully. As we on the timer, the output will be come after the time delay of 5 seconds. The output bit is high now.